All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Christopher Moreau, the CEO of Algernon Pharmaceuticals. And Chris, it's great to have you back again. How are you?
I'm good, Steve. We haven't seen each other for a few weeks.
Yeah, it's nice to have you back. And some news to talk about today. You've completed 50% of your patient enrollment for your most recent clinical study. So maybe just remind everyone a little bit about what this study is looking at.
So Algernon is running a phase two clinical trial for Ifenprodil for idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, for short IPF, and for chronic cough. It's a 20-patient open label study. It's being run in Australia and New Zealand. And our last milestone we announced was 25% enrollment, and we've just achieved 50%. I'm hoping that things are going to continue to move more quickly. We've had some delays in the trial, which we can chat about in the interview. Delays in terms of enrollment, and so 50%, and obviously we're hoping we can come back and announce 75% and then full enrollment. But that was the news yesterday.
Yeah, let's talk about that, because I was going to ask you that question. It seems like the patient enrollment has been going slow. Is that normal?
You know, it's relative. You know, there's a few key issues. First off, we are doing the study in Australia and New Zealand. We're doing it because there's a 40% refundable tax credit. But on the other hand, it's a small market overall. Mm-hmm. And idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis is an orphan indication, meaning a very small percentage of the population have the disease. There are lots of other companies doing IPF trials research in Australia. So you have a competitive situation with clinics. A broker asked me yesterday, it's a big country. Why is it taking so long? But the trial isn't really open to the entire country. You're working with clinics and investigators that you've signed up who have a patient population that are going through the trial. These are very ill people. If you have IPF, you probably have a three-year lifespan. We've been going through COVID. There's lockdowns, telemedicine. You can't do this over the phone. You have to come in. If you don't live in the town or city where the clinic is, you have to travel there. So it's just a natural process. Sometimes trials for diseases that are orphan indications take longer. It's just the way things go. So patience is key, pun intended.
Okay. Algernon, obviously extremely busy, and you put out a release today talking about this is the COVID study, and specifically a marker that you found that relates to what we're talking about right now with interleukin. Maybe you can kind of explain this marker and why this is so significant in the one that you're we're talking about, the Australia New Zealand clinical study.
Right. Well, all clinical trials are informative. And so we happen to have been studying Ifenprodil, investigating it for our COVID trial. IL-6 or interleukin 6 is a tiny protein cytokine. It's involved in inflammation. It's involved in communication. It modulates the inflammatory response. And what we found interesting in our COVID data is that at day 5, there was a dramatic reduction of IL-6. Which we can ascribe to the Ifenprodil dose in the 20 milligram group. Why that I think is important, generally it's important because if you're modulating IL-6, you're reducing an inflammatory response, which can be overstated, especially in a respiratory condition. That's what COVID can cause, a cytokine storm. But it's a very short storm for COVID. You know, 85% of patients who are hospitalized are getting better anyway and leaving the hospital. In IPF, it's a chronic condition, so one might expect that IL-6 may be high throughout the duration of the disease. And so noting that in the COVID study, and then looking, there were two studies that we noted in today's release that that IL-6 was involved in fibrosis. And so it's it's possibly informative for the company that that the control of IL-6 in our IPF study may help us understand how Ifenprodil could be working.
Okay, super fascinating stuff. I know we'll have you back very soon to talk more about it, especially as the patient enrollment increases. So, Chris, thank you very much. Great to see you again.
Good to see you, Steve. Take care.
All right, Christopher Moreau, the CEO of Algernon Pharmaceuticals. We'll be right back.